neither. Good morning. Welcome back on this Thursday morning. Let's quickly go over the forecast. Much of what you saw yesterday, you'll see again today. Only 20% chance of rain. About 65 degrees out there right now. High temperatures of 86. Ditto for tomorrow. It looks like Saturday, 70% chance of those showers, or actually just a rainfall, that is. So it's going to be a rainy weekend, Saturday and
Y'all
Sunday.
Y'all may be playing in the rain Friday night.
They may.
Coach Lick, congratulations.
Thanks, sir.
Great article this morning in Decatur Daily. Football magic is returning to Ardmore. And what I couldn't believe says in the past 30 seasons, Ardmore has averaged less than 3 wins a season.
Wow.
We've reached that quota.
Yeah, you already
got above.
You're already above
that. About that.
What's your magic going on this year? That lucky guy on the sideline with you?
No. It's no magic. It's being able to run the football and working hard. That's why we're winning.
Well, you got to be totally amazed that you're 3-0. Your rookie season as a head coach.
We won 3 games.
Don't think so.
That's it. We work real hard, and the kids have worked real hard. You know, I don't know. I think hard work and running the football and being stronger, and that's the only chance we got.
How's your support up there right now, being 3-0? What are the people in Ardmore saying?
Well, pretty good, but, you know, I try to keep our kids down, and not down, but, you know, on level ground. There's a lot of people, man, you beat, you know. It was a big win Friday night, but it was one win, and that's – Well, I'm trying to remind
North Jackson
kids.
For the first
I'm
time.
I'm trying to remind
overtime.
Our kids one win.
I heard he's been giving women rides on motorcycles.
Hi, Lily, Lucy.
And to the other point, Jeff, you can't catch a break.
You got to make your breaks. I told you that a while ago. We got better. Kids played harder. Just about 3 or 4 plays, we let slip away and let another victory slip away. I feel bad for our kids because they really worked hard, played hard. And we led the whole game till 7 minutes to go in the game. Mm. And then just couldn't get the plays made. Had a couple of chances to put them away. And could have got up on them 10 points right there at the end and didn't do it. You know, they're learning right now the hard way. And been in this business a long time. It'll pay off for them later on down the
How hard road. Is it to sleep on a Friday night when you get beat?
I don't sleep anyway. until you get some satisfaction for your kids, if you really care about what you're doing, you know, it's tough on you. Right now, we need to win a football game.
Now, y'all go to Lawrence County this week?
Yes.
All right. Where you go, Clint?
Randolph.
Okay. So you'll be 4-0 after this week. Huh. Oh, and you'll get your first victory, too.
He will.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. Well, I know it's, you know, one going along, one going the other. But you had a tough friggin' set region,
it's
man.
That's tough, but, you know, you don't get to pick your schedule. That's the way it goes. You got to take them on one at a time.
And see, Ardmore talking about Eugene Cooper is smiling somewhere, says, now I remember they played us one year at New Hope. I was defensive halfback. How'd that go, Frank? It was 28-0 in like the first friggin' quarter.
Yeah, you don't share a lot of football stories.
There ain't nothing to share. That's good. But Eugene Cooper, a legend up there.
Aww.
And our good friend and partner with some river property, if y'all need to buy that, y'all need to call Marmack Real Estate over there. Johnny Bailey was the quarterback, led them to the state title back in the 66, I think, if I remember correctly, back in then. All right, let's switch subject, talk about Alabama game this past week. Man, could that have been more exciting? We should have beaten them 21 points.
Yeah, I'm worried. I'm telling you, I'm worried about our secondary. I think our safeties are okay, but you know, at corner, we got exposed big time. And I know they had to do a lot of man coverage outside to try to put pressure on him, but it didn't look like to me we got enough pressure on him by playing man. But the big thing is a couple weeks, we play Ole Miss, and I think that quarterback's pretty good, and they got some good receivers too, so we better do some improving in the secondary.
I don't think we can be beat.
I hope not.
You better not.
I'm confident one. But Manziel, did he prove that he's that good?
He's good.
He's just
got some good receivers too.
He's good. Yeah, you know,
take away that number 13. How good is he?
Yeah. But also, let's look at AJ McCarron. Fantastic ball game. Offensive line.
That really bothers me. All we hear about is Johnny football. You got a guy that's won 2 national championships, and every time he gets on the field,
and as humble as can be,
nobody talks about him.
Yeah,
I'd rather have a winner anytime.
He's in the top 5 right now in the Heisman for this year. What is your take on the football season so far at college?
Well, first of all, last year, Jeff and I get there early enough where we go down to the visiting locker room and watch him come on the field. 13 come out there last year. If he's 6'5", then I'm 6 foot tall. And my brother-in-law is 6'8", and he's all of that tall. So he's not 6'5". Let's make that clear.
So he's big.
He's huge. But I mean, Jeff will admit this too. Saban coaches the cornerbacks, yeah, and they will get better. So I'm not worried.
If they get better like the offensive line did, we ain't got no worries.
Right.
But, yeah, I agree with you on Jeff on McCarron. He does not get the credit he deserves.
Good.
All right, guys, well, good luck this weekend. We'll see y'all
Thursday.
And both of y'all come away, and you'll still be – you'll get the first win.
You'll
be undefeated.
I hope so.
And you can go to steak night tonight up at Ardmore. Gloria's going to make her way over to the kitchen. Don't forget steak night coming up tonight right at Pizza Inn.
Uh-huh.
So let's get a move on here. I'll get over to the kitchen. Steak night tonight starts at 5 o'clock. It'll be packed.
You can be there at 4:50, though, Jamie. Zeke can serve you there.
Yeah, get there where Zeke can get things cranking. As Gloria makes her finally her way over to the kitchen.
I'm getting there.
How long is this going to take? I can't pause.
It's hooked up.
Yeah. All right, let's go over to the kitchen. We're going to talk with some folks in Hartselle in just a second, too. We'll do a little bit of news coming up, and we'll also hear from Danny Roadrunner, Beep Beep Johnson, coming up later. I think he goes dove hunting. All right, let's make our way to the kitchen now. Finally, Zeke, roll tide.
No.
Zeke's on the state line. He's afraid to say all that.
I just can't do it.
So you don't have to. You don't have to. How are you?
Good, good, good.
It smells wonderful in here. What'd you make?
Well, today we're going to, tonight at 5 o'clock, we're going to, at steak night, we're going to do something different today. We're going to do a shrimp Alfredo and a chicken Alfredo. And it comes with a salad for $9.99. And then a breast of chicken with the salad and any kind of vegetable like fried squash, green beans, macaroni and cheese, sweet potatoes. We do have a 10-ounce ribeye that I think is just awesome. And you can't get it for $11.99 anywhere else. So,
and when you talk about shrimp Alfredo, I mean, you actually have good-sized shrimp and plenty of it.
Yeah, there's 16. They're the biggest shrimp that we can use. And they're really good. And they're really inexpensive, so we use them.
All right. Okay, tell me about your hours.
Well, Sunday through Thursday, it's 11 to 9, and then Friday and Saturday until 10 o'clock. But when Ardmore plays in town, we stay open until 11 o'clock so people can come and get a pizza or a salad.
Speaking about pizzas, those specials taking place?
Yes.
Always special, so really just count on it.
Every day, all day, and we deliver every day, all day. So.
If you have not tried his catering, or if you're putting together a party, whether it be large or small, I highly, highly recommend them. We had Jamie's birthday party. The food was amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, you know, I mean, we do a lot more than what a pizza place would do. And you know, we live there. We own it. So, I mean, we just try to do whatever we can, Kathy and I.
You guys work extremely hard, and I mean, you go above and beyond what is, I mean, you called in the middle of the party. Do you need any more food?
True. True. I mean, you don't want to run out, and then what are you going to serve them, chips? So.
Not at our house. Zeke had it going on and taken care of. Well, thank you very much. There's Pizza Inn. Give them a call. Keep that number close in case you get hungry. You want to order that pizza, 423-2500. Anything else you want to say?
That's it. Thank you.
He didn't get you to say it.
Do I? No.
We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.